Hey dear viewers, this is Ronald speaking and welcome to my channel. This video is the third of my spherical shell series and I will cover geometric imperfections like eigenmode, dimple, local flattening and reduced stiffness analysis. Okay, and in the next part we start right into abacus. Okay, in this part we will discuss the different imperfection methods. First we will start with the eigenform imperfection. You have to use your numerical model of the spherical cap. And in this case, we have to first create the eigenform data. Therefore, we have to go to the step manager, Barkel, and check, okay, we will look at the first 10 eigenvalues. Okay, and the rest is fine. So how do we create the first data for the eigenform imperfections? We go to model. Added keywords, then LBA, so it has to be the same as this, LBA, LBA. And then we go to the end of the file and we input here some data. I have prepared it already here in my Excel sheet. So we have to add those lines, node file and U. Let's see if it works. Yeah, like this. Okay, and then we go to, let's check the model again. I haven't touched it in a while. Okay, looks fine. Okay, let's check the material data, elastic, yeah, okay, all looks fine. Okay, then we go to job and then we just run the job again. Okay, and in the next part, when the calculation is complete, we will discuss how to input the data to the geometrically nonlinear analysis. Okay, the calculation is now complete. We can again check the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors or eigenforms. Okay, and now in the work directory, we have the corresponding imperfection file. It's this file here, the lba.fill. Here are the imperfection data and how do we import it? We go to a new model. Let's copy this GNA and eigenform imperfection. Okay, we have to check some stuff first. Okay, looks about right. That's also fine. Pressure load is analytical, yes. Material is, it's still elastic. Okay, that's okay. Okay, we have to go now to, again, to to model keywords and then GNI eigenform imperfection, and here we have to look for end assembly here. Then I go back to my imperfection detail and here you have to look for end assembly, and then afterwards you have to import this line like this. So it's called it's a star imperfection comma file, and then equal, and here has to be the job name, which is LBA. We have only one step, and then we can choose as the next line. The first number is the eigenmode. We have 10, and this is the first eigenmode. If I choose it like this, we would have the third eigenmode, or the fifth, or the sixth. But in my experience, it doesn't really matter that much. So we will choose the first, and comma, and the next number represents the scaling factor in comparison to the thickness. So if we use one, we scale it to the imperfection amplitude to the thickness of the model. So we will use this for the purpose of comparison. And then I will create the next model, GNA eigenform imperfection. Okay, and in the next part we will look at the results. Okay, the calculation is now complete and let's have a look at the results. You already see that here the global deformations are similar to the first eigenmode. I can show the first eigenmode again here. Yeah, this is the first eigenmode. Ah, we can just use two windows. So we have here the first eigenmode and here we have the corresponding simulation. So let's have a look at the... This is a deformation behavior with a slight increase in pressure. Let's have a look at the deformation behavior. Okay, so this is a deformation behavior when this eigenmode is scaled to the shell thickness and then applied to the shell surface. Okay, and the pressure is about, let's check the pressure load. The maximum pressure is .7819. So let's check our Excel sheet. So this is the GNA. Eigen mode or imperfection and elastic. And we have bucketing pressure of 7.819. Yes. Yeah. We can also look at the shape of the pressure. Okay, looks like this. No sharp drop in pressure load after buckling. So, and as I said, in the real measured imperfection led to a buckling load for elastic buckling to about 13 meganewtons, megapascals. And okay, now let's perform the same analysis with the same eigenmode imperfection but with plastic material behavior. Therefore, we want to copy this, copy model and add here PP for perfectly plastic. And we just go to material, mechanical plasticity plastic and add here the yield stress, which is 335 and plastic strain 0. Okay, now we will perform the same analysis and we look at the results. Copy model, eigenform imperfection, PP. And here now it's geometrically material nonlinear analysis. So GMNA. Okay, and in the next part we will look at the results. Okay, the calculation is now complete for our eigenform imperfection or eigenmode imperfection model with plastic material behavior. And let's have a look at the deformation behavior first. So this is in the first increment after we have applied a small percentage of the pressure load. And then it looks like this here. Here's a large buckle. Okay, and the pressure is actually very low because, like I said, we have scaled the first eigenmode to one time of the shell thickness. We have a pressure load of about 2.6. So, this is of course lower than the test pressure of 5.25, but it's too low for my taste. Just one additional computation with the eigenmode imperfection. We go to keywords again, eigenmode imperfection here, and then we will change the amplitude to 0.5 of the shear thickness, not 1. Maybe this will increase the buckling pressure to a more result which is more close to the test result of 5. Okay, this will be looked at in the next part of the video. Okay, now we have the results of the second analysis with the eigenmode imperfection only has the amplitude is half of the shear thickness, and I have already looked for the corresponding maximum pressure. It's now 3.41. We can here 3.41, so it's about 30% higher than the result with 1x shear thickness imperfection. Okay, okay, that's it for this imperfection model. We can also compare the shape of the shell in the first step after the corresponding small percentage pressure load has been applied. You can already see here, this is a 1x imperfection model, 1x the shear thickness, and this is a 0.5x the shear thickness model. You can already see that this model has a smaller amplitude imperfection than this one. So this methodology works actually quite well. Okay, in the next video we will take a look at the different imperfection model, because this one is not as realistic as the other message, which I will present later. Okay, we will see you in the next part. Okay, in this part we will create another imperfection, a dimple imperfection. Therefore we will use our regular model, copy it, and then we will create two models. Dimple 0.5T and perfectly plastic. Then we will add here perfect plastic material behavior again, plastic. And we will add another step, create step 0, static general, nonlinear, I think that's okay. Okay, let's check the boundary conditions. This has to be moved to initial, the boundary conditions, and the pressure load only step 1, and then in the first step we will create a dimple, displacement rotation at the shell apex, and the amplitude is minus 0.5, like this step 0 which we have just created, and then here deactivate, and then we copy the same model and look at it with 1x the dimple imperfection. And here we just minus 1. Then we will just create the dimple 0.05. We could have done it like this, pp, and copy the model and use 1t. Okay, and in the next video we look at the results. Okay, small correction part. We have to go to step, and here we have to move the field output to left and history output also. Then the simulation will start. Okay, in the next part we will hopefully see the results. Okay, in this part we will look at the results of the dimple imperfection analysis. First we look at the results for 0.5 dimple amplitude of the chest thickness. And the deformation behavior looks like this. We have in step 0 we have applied the dimple imperfection. And then the behavior looks like this here. And the pressure loads, the maximum pressure is 1.719. So also very low, 1.719 dimple. That's not good. That is far too low, so dimple imperfections greatly reduce the buckling pressure. And what do we have here? First look at the deformation behavior. Okay, here 1 times the chest thickness, and deformation behavior looks like this, not really that different. And the maximum pressure is like 1.613, so not that different. But as you can see, it's a high reduction of the buckling pressure. Okay. In this part of the video, we will perform a flat patch imperfection analysis. Therefore, we use our conventional model, copy model, flat patch imperfection. Okay, now we go to part and we go to the sketch. Okay, here we will create 2 points. Or now align better. First point is 24 and 0, second point is 24 and 100. Okay, this will be our reference line. Now we create a new circle, and as far as I know, the recommended size of the circle for the flat patch imperfection is about 1.3 times the radius. So the radius is 90.51, so 100 and let's take 118. So the origin of our circle, of our sphere, is 0 and 0. And now we have to use So we have to reduce the circle radius y coordinate by 27. So pick a center point for the circle, x is 0 and the y coordinate is 27. Okay, and now we choose this point here, 0 and minus 27. Okay, now, yeah, that's better. And now we choose this point here. Because I want that the flat patch has a radius of 24. Okay, now we can trim. We can trim this, and this. And let's zoom in and have a look. And now you can see that we have here a slight deviation of the curvature path. Okay, it's done. Regenerate. Keep changes. And now we have to create new partitions using the datum plane method. Select the faces here. Yes. Oh. This was the wrong plane. This plane. And this plane. Okay, property. Looks like we have to reassign the property. Okay, now it looks fine. Assembly is fine. Boundary conditions have to be reassigned. Dismiss. And select this, then STGD, select the rest. Let's check it, looks okay. And the yes, surface has also be has to be reassigned. Brown. Okay, mesh. Medial quad. And okay, now we can create the job. GNA flat patch imperfection. Okay. As the next part, we will look at the results. Okay, in this video, we will take a look at the results of the flat patch analysis. Here we have let's have a look at the first loading step. You can see already here that we have a flattening slightly and the deformation behavior looks like this. Okay, and the maximum pressure is .4637. So GNA flat patch imperfection 1.3 radius and 24 millimeters and perfect plastic and it's 4.637. So it's conservative with respect to the exponential result and higher than those. Also, we can just add a new row. I have performed another dimple analysis with 0.1 thickness. And for this, we had a result of 5.23 megapascals for the pressure load. But as you can see that this is a parameter problem. You have many parameters and you don't know which you have to choose. And at least for the flat imperfection, you have some guidelines. The guideline is the flat patch circle has a radius of 1.3 times the spherical radius and the width is about 33% of the base radius. Okay, that's it for this part. And in this part of the video, we will perform a reduced stiffness analysis. Therefore, we use our conventional model. Then we copy it and rename it. And then we the name is LRSM for localized reduced stiffness method. Okay, and herefore we need a new section. We go to the section manager, create, and here you can see section general shell stiffness. Continue, and here we need stiffness matrix components, which are based on the ABD composite stiffness matrix. And in order to calculate the components, I have prepared a Python script, which can be seen here. This Python script calculates the ABD composite stiffness matrix components, and it's called, the function is called devclt. Okay, I just show here the function. I will add it in the download description, and here is the elasticity modulus of our shell, the Poisson ratio of our shell, and for our function we need this material in terms of a composite. So we need A11, A22, G12, Nu12, the laminate stacking, the laminate thickness, and the ply number. So for isotropic material, we can assume this, that E11 and E22 are the same. The Nu12 is the Poisson ratio of the isotropic material. The shear modulus can be calculated according to this formula. The laminate is assumed to be quasi-isotropic. The ply number is the length of this list, it's 8. And the laminate thickness is the shell thickness, which is 1 millimeter divided by the ply number. And if we run the script and go to the variable manager, we have here the entries or the components of the ABD stiffness matrix. And I have already copied them into Excel just to show you. We have here the A matrix, the membrane stiffness matrix. The coupling stiffness matrix is 0 because we have an isotropic material. And here is the bending stiffness matrix, the D matrix. And you may already know that the A matrix, the B and the D matrix are symmetric. So we don't need those entries here. And for the reduced stiffness method, we divide those entries, every component by 10. So here we have the entries. Then we can copy those and paste them here. This is 0 for every entry. Okay. And this is like this. And the D components look like this. Okay, here we have now the stiffness matrix. Now we need to create a partition. Therefore, I need to know the distance from here to here. The distance is 72. Okay. Now we go to part and we create a partition using the sketch method. We select the faces we want to partition, then we select the plane, this one, through all. Flip direction is okay. We select this edge. Okay, then we copy this one and times 0.33. Okay, it's 24, so we create a circle with origin 0, 0 and radius is 24. Okay, done. Now we have here a partition and we change this set. We deselect those, so it's strg and mouse. And then we create a new set, this one, and select this section. And let's, now we have two sections, the reduced stiffness section and the conventional shell section. Okay, now we have to change. Let's look. The boundary conditions are still fine. Okay. The surface for the pressure load has to be adjusted. Brown. Okay. Then the mesh. And yeah. Okay, now we can create the job on transit simulation, and then we will look in the next part at the results. Okay, in this part we will take a look at the reduced stiffness method results. Keep in mind that we perform the analysis with plastic, perfectly plastic material behavior. I think I forgot this setting. Okay, let's check the result now. Here the result. Deformation behavior looks like this. Nothing too special. And the pressure load is 4.55. Let's have a look at the behavior of the pressure after buckling. Okay, looks good. And yeah, it's I just LRSM 10 reduction RBD, and the radius is also 24 millimeters, like the flat patch analysis. And the buckling pressure was 4.45. So you can see that those methods deliver relatively good estimations for the real buckling pressure. But yeah, you need some guidelines for the parameter sets. For the LSM, you have the reduction factor of the ABD matrix, which is according to my experience 10 is a good value, and the other parameter, the radius of the flat of the imperfection radius, has to be found by using some iteration. Same goes for the flat patch imperfection. The official guideline is the flat patch circle has 1.3 times the radius of the shell radius, and the 24 millimeters has to be found by using iteration. Okay, this is the summary part of this video. Let's check out our Excel sheet again. Here are all the results of our analysis, and I have also summarized them on this sheet here. And I have summarized here the different eigenmode imperfections, dimple, local flattening and reduced stiffness method. And I have also run some more additional jobs in order to find some imperfection amplitude which fits the test result better. Okay, and as you can see, for the eigenmode imperfection is 0.25 of the shell thickness, so a quarter. The dimple imperfection is 10% of the shell thickness, and the other methods work reasonably well. But the main problem of all imperfection concepts is that you don't know how to restrict the corresponding imperfection. So what do we do? I have found an alternative method. It's based on this article by Professor Yevgen, Design Buckling Pressures for Thin-Walled Spherical Shells. And I will show you the corresponding equations. So it's a pure analytical concept. First, you need to determine knockdown factor according to the energy barrier criterion. It's this equation here, and this equation only depends on the shell shape parameter lambda. Okay, then you get a Noctan factor 0.22. Then you need another value, the ratio of yield pressure to classic pressure. So this and this and the square root of both. Here. You can see clearly the equation here. And then we need another value. This is the Noctan factor. And it's the ratio of the Noctan factor and the square root of this lambda value and the Noctan factor. And then here, this value depends on the boundary conditions. It's 1 for complete spheres and it's 0.9 for clamped edges. So our example. Okay, and then you can calculate the corresponding Noctan factor like this. You can see here the relations in the Excel sheet. Okay, and then you get the Noctan factor of 0.17 and the design pressure is 4.8. So this pressure is below the test value and it's relatively good in compared to the numerical methods, but as you see, it's poor analytical, so that's very good. Okay, that's for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.